Don't you just love the smell of fresh parcels in the morning? Yep, something arrived today. Don't worry, I won't keep you in suspense. Much. Well, let's take a look, shall we? We start off with this, a circuit board. But what on earth is that white round thing in the center, surrounded by some pretty meaty looking capacitors? A black thing. Some very strange looking standoffs. They're tall. This will give the game away. The little bear, P1. Valve amplifier. And here is the valve that came with it. This one is a Chinese manufacturer. But I also have a few more. I have some from Philips, GE and Telefunken. The aim there is to see if what all these people have been talking about on forums is actually true. The Little Bear P1 is quite a common little headphone valve amplifier. It does have an output as well, so it does serve as a sort of a line amp, but it requires a little touch of assembly, not very much. A crosshead screwdriver, and I'll be finished with that in about 10 minutes. I'm a bit concerned about the transformer that came with it, though. As you can see, this apparently is a switching adapter. If they can't even spell right, then, you know, this is a bit light for a switching adapter. We'll see how it goes. Plus, I've got to chop the end off there and put a British plug on it. And we'll see how it goes, considering it's 24 volts DC. Shouldn't be too hard to get another one, if that doesn't prove to do the job. But hang on, I hear you say. What's that? Another transformer? Yes. Because this also arrived. It's the Little Bear P2-1. Another valve headphone amp, but this has two valves in it, and it also runs oddly from 12 volts AC. I wonder what they're doing inside here. Fortunately, this came fully assembled. However, even though that one says 12 volts AC, the AC-AC adapter that came with it says 18 volts AC. I've got another problem with this, because the prongs can't easily be replaced on this, so I'm trying to source another adapter to take its place that has a British prongs on it, so to speak. Hence the extra valves here. There's actually another three Chinese valves there. And I have two Philips, two GE, and two Telefunken to test with. We shall see in due course what we shall see. Now, they're going to be driven by this. This is the USB Box S by Project. It's the word project with a hyphen between the O and the J. Now, they actually do a number of different boxes in this range. This is just a DAC, a digital to analog converter, and it's stereo only. It does have a predecessor, which is just the USB box without the S. The S is the next step up and received about 4 out of 5 stars in a Watt Hi-Fi review. It takes an input from USB, does the conversion, through the power that's also drawn through the USB, so it doesn't need a separate transformer, and it throws the analog signal out of the phono sockets at the back. There is a USB box S Plus. Now the S Plus does actually require its own transformer, but it does so because at the back it also has optical and coax digital inputs. But even with that, it only achieves the higher bit rates through the optical and the coax. To explain, what they say is through the USB you can transmit CD audio quality, which basically 44.1 kHz, all the rest of that jazz, 16-bit. If you want to go up to 24-bit or any higher sampling rates, then you've got to go optical. You can't do that via USB. Bit of a shame, but there you go. Makes me wonder what's actually inside here. Hence, it needs the power. So this one, I thought, you know, I don't need anything more than CD audio quality. That's going to do me quite fine, thank you very much. And I can do without an extra wall wart to feed. So I went for the S. Now I've already had this powered up and fed to the Yamaha amp, and it actually sounds quite nice. In another video, when I've got all this straightened out, I'm going to be doing a bit of a presentation into the things that we had to consider for the last 20 to 30 years when dealing with PCs and audio. You know, when you're dealing with the retro community, I mean, many of the people who used to run as far back as the 8-bit consoles and machines and computers would tell you that if they hooked their equipment up to a separate amplifier, you know, something that had a bit of quality behind it, they would get a better quality sound out of their computer and console, which was, you know, it sort of stood to reason. And there were a few bits and pieces that still even apply to PCs. So in a future video, I'm going to go through all that. Well, I'm just going to go through the PC side of things, really, to show you where the things are that we used to have to consider, and some of these things we still have to consider now. And, and why I made some of the choices that I made. And not all of them are to do with quality, some of them are to do with practicalities as well, because this is quite a bit of a mix of things. So, tonight I am going to fire up these headphone amps, run them up, and see what I can get out of them. This should be assembled in about 10 minutes flat, so that shouldn't take any trouble. Cutting this off, rephasing it another 5 minutes, 10 minutes, because I got the plug ready. And there we go. Interestingly enough, there is one more piece that I'm waiting on, but that's nothing to do with the headphones. That is still a valve, but it's a line amp. Now, interestingly, most people say that when they receive these, they typically get a spare as well as the valve to go in it, which I didn't receive with the little bare P1. I did with the P2. I received two valves and a spare. With this one, there was only one. So we'll see whether how many spares there are in the other amp that's coming, and we'll take it from there. So for now, I'm going to bid you adieu and get stuck in with a screwdriver and put this lot together. And then I can set to work working out whether some of what these people have been saying is true on the internet is or isn't true. Bye for now.